Hello and welcome to this video tutorial brought to you by tastytutes.com. In this tutorial, I'll be talking in some depth about the links panel in Adobe InDesign. The links panel in InDesign is one of the biggest panels and it has great focus in this program. This panel represents all the image elements that you will have within your document, and you're going to need to pay close attention to this panel. This panel is pretty crucial to your workflow, so in this tutorial, I'm going to explain exactly how this works and how you can customize this panel so you can get more detailed information about your images to get complete control of your images in your document. To demonstrate this, I'm going to use the complete project document so I can see it in action. In the last video, I recommended an InDesign workspace and demonstrated how to set it up in this way. In this tutorial, we are going to focus on the links panel, located here in the top panel group. If you don't have your workspace set up like this, you can either watch the previous video, Adobe InDesign Interface Introduction, or simply you can come up to Window, scroll down and activate the links panel here. So here's the links panel, and I can currently see this contains a list. This is a list of all the image elements within my document. Every time you place an image into your document, place it in the pasteboard area or in the composition area, it will show up in this panel. Now what you are seeing is the default setup of the links panel when you start InDesign. The links panel can be customized. For example, I'm going to come to Window, come down to Workspace, and here I have a workspace I have prepared earlier called TastyT. So I'm just going to click on this, and my workspace will change. Though it has not changed massively, what you can see now are these extra properties visible here in the links panel. So starting from the left, I have name, status, page number, color space, actual PPI, and size. Now these are additional properties columns that can be activated in the links panel. These are here to clearly display information about an image in the document at a glance. And these are pretty crucial to help you keep on top of your project and maintain the quality you will later need in order to get the document printed. Now, I highly recommend you have these extra properties columns in your links panel like this. But before I explain why and the benefits, I will quickly show you how to get them here. So first, I'm going to come back to my previous workspace with the default links panel. Back up to Window, down to Workspace, and click on my TastyT Work 2 workspace. So now I am back to the default links panel, and we no longer see the properties columns. Now I'm going to simply come to the top right of my links panel, click the menu, and activate your panel options. And here you can choose from a vast variety of properties. For now, all I'm going to need is the properties mentioned previously. So I'm going to go ahead and click to activate the ones I want. So I will click on size, click on color space, and lastly, click on actual PPI, and then click OK. Once you have these loaded, it's up to you what order you have them, but you can actually click and drag the tabs left and right to change the order. So I'm going to order them like so. So let's go through what each column is and why I need these. First, I have name. This will show the file name of an image, item, and a little thumbnail to the left. You'll also be able to see the file extension. Next, I have page number. This basically states which page the image is on. Now, for example, if I drag an image off a page and onto the pasteboard, you will notice the page number changed to PB. This stands for pasteboard. Next, I have status. This will tell me the status of the image. If any image links are broken or if any image needs refreshing, you will see the warning icon clearly here in this column. Next, I have actual PPI. This will tell me the resolution of the image. I cannot stress how useful this is. If you're composing a document that is going to print, then you will need at least 300 DPI. So if you place an image that is 72 or lower, for example, then you will be able to see it here and address the image straight away before finding out later. I can see here that all my images are 300 DPI. Next, I have the color space. Again, very useful. As you may already know, images can either be RGB or CMYK. If you're creating a document ready for print, all images will need to be CMYK. So again, this will be very useful to keep your eye on. And I can see that all my images here are CMYK. So I have size. This will tell me the document size of the image. This is for convenience. There's nothing particularly important about this other than peace of mind. So these are the key properties columns you should have open to keep on top of your images. Now I want to draw your attention to the bottom of the links panel. With an image selected above, I can see some extra information about the image, such as the name, file path on your computer, and so on. Now, if I look just above this link info area, to the right, I can see four buttons. These are pretty important, and you will need to familiarize yourself with these. Starting from the left, I have the relink button, then the go to link, then refresh, and edit original. The relink button will enable you to change the image. If I have an image placed in my composition area, but I want to replace it with another one, I can easily do this using this button. Simply click the image you wish to replace, then hit this button and navigate to the new image on your computer. Next to this, you have the Go To button. This is convenient if you have a large document with a lot of images, or perhaps an image that is sitting in the pasteboard somewhere. With the image in question selected above, you can click this button and it will take you straight to the image in your composition, like so. The next button is the Update Link button. Now, let's say you had to make changes to an image. Let's say you were working on some document images while your InDesign document was open, but you did not have it on screen. So I'm going to minimize InDesign and come to an image in my Documents Asset folder and just open an image. Let's say this motorbike image here. In Photoshop, I'll just duplicate the layer and take the saturation right down so it looks almost grayscale. Then I will close and save the file. Now let's open up my InDesign document and take a look in the links panel. Now we can see a warning icon in the status column. And if I click on the image and press the Go To button, we can see that the image we just changed to grayscale is still in color. Now in the links panel, this is InDesign telling me that this image has been changed or modified and that I need to refresh the image. So if I now press the Update Link button, the bike will now change to the up-to-date state, and we can see that it's now grayscale and the warning icon has disappeared. So looking back at the icons on the bottom of the panel, on the far right I have the Edit Original button. Now you may find yourself using this button a lot, so once an image is placed in your InDesign composition, there may be times you may wish to make modifications to that image, change the color, create transparency, or just make simple photo manipulations. So let's come back to the image I just changed into grayscale. If I want to change it back to the color version, I can use the selection tool to select the image frame. Now the image will also become selected in the links panel. If I come down to the Edit Original button and click that, InDesign will then open the image in Adobe Photoshop. So I'm going to go ahead and change my image. This time I'm going to remove the grayscale layer I created earlier by simply toggling the visibility. Then if I save and close the image, then come back into InDesign, you will then notice the image automatically updates and I can see the changes I just made. So that's the links panel in InDesign and some of its functionality. This is one of the important panels in InDesign and I find myself keeping an eye on this one regularly. So it may now come as no surprise why I keep it visible in the large top panel group of my workspace like this. So now I'm confident I know about the interface and I'm happy with my workspace setup. I'm ready to start my document. In the next video, I'm going to start to build my composition with placeholder frame boxes ready to introduce my images and text. So I'll see you in the next video.